Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer of Metallic Preaching Christianity and Sikhism. We are under Exposition Act 19:1-20. And it came to pass that while Apollos was at Corinth, Paul, having passed through the upper coast, came to Ephesus, and finding certain laborers and not disciples in Christ Jesus. In Christ Jesus we have laborers which are twice born, and they, like the Apollos, they are outspoken. So he said unto them, have ye received the Holy Spirit and not Holy Ghost as they written in the Bible? Because Holy Ghost is this wisdom of men, Holy Spirit is the very Spirit of God, wisdom of God. Since you believed, so he asked them, you know, that because they have been working hard and preaching gospel, so he asked them whether you have got Holy Spirit. And they said unto him, we have not so much as heard whether there be any Holy Spirit. So they were so, you know, well trained workers that they did not know that they need anything else. And he said unto them, unto what then were ye baptized? And they said, unto John's baptism, which was of men. John's baptism makes you son of man, and the baptism of Christ Jesus, the Eucharist, makes you the son of God. And then Saint Paul, John verily baptized with the baptism of repentance, that in case you have become a Jew of the flesh, so it in repentance that they were made the sons of Abraham back to his son of man, saying unto the people that they should believe on him which should come after him, that is on Christ Jesus. When they heard this, they were neither baptized in water in the name of our anointed elder brother, Christ Jesus, nor in the name of Lord Jesus as the Antichrist are propagating, but he rather served them, Saint Paul rather served them the Eucharist of sacrifice. Eucharist of sacrifice is the baptism of Christ Jesus in Holy Spirit. So that engaging them into the ministry of preaching gospel. That means after you have got this Eucharist of sacrifice, you then do not do secular work. You devote your life 100% to preaching of gospel, and that is why, you know, the people who get the Eucharist, they take to wilderness. Wilderness means soil which is free of the weeds. So there is a corruption in this Bible, and there is so many corruption antichrists have made. Remember that these Jewish people who were staunch enemy of the apostles, they were the one who start to dominate the church after the end of the first century, when it became corrupt and they throw the apostles out. So they corrupted the Bible, and you find so many corruptions over there. But they are not major, they are minor. And when Paul had laid his hands upon them, the Holy Spirit and not Holy Ghost came on them. Holy Spirit was the very wage which Christ Jesus, the foreman, paid to his workers at Pentecost. So same here, Saint Paul paid the wages to these men, which is the Holy Spirit. And they spake with tongues and prophesied. So they then spoke with tongues and prophesied, because Holy Spirit knows the things of God. The Holy Spirit with small s knows the things of men. Spirit of men knows the spirit of men, whereas the Spirit of God knows the very matters of the heart of the people. And all the men were about 12, so there were about 12 people who were baptized into the Eucharist and who had received their wage of Holy Spirit. And he went into the synagogue and spake boldly for the space of 3 months, disputing and persuading the things concerning the royal kingdom of God. Remember that Christ Jesus came to proclaim to us the royal kingdom of God, and that's why the Jews called him a king, and they incited the secular king Pilate that he is having a parallel kingdom to you, but we like your kingdom, not of this royal kingdom. But when divers were hardened and believed not, so divers mean the Jews who were hardened and they would not believe, they only knew scripture as in the Jerusalem. They were drunk with the old wine of the letters, they desired not the new, so there were some also Jews. But spake evil of that way before the multitude, he departed from them and separated the laborers and not his disciple, disputing daily in the school of one Tyrannus. And this continued by the space of 2 years, so that all they which dwelt in Asia heard the word of our Father God, in honor of our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus, and not the Lord, as the people Antichrist proclaim, both Jews and Greek. So those Greek Jews who were twice born and who were living, and Greeks, they were mostly twice born. Very few were the dead one, once born. And God wrought special miracles by the hands of St. Paul, so that from his body were brought unto the sick handkerchiefs or aprons, and the diseases departed from them, and the evil spirits went out of them. So those who believed in Christ Jesus and those who have faith in God, though they were healed, while those who were doubting in their hearts, that did not work for them. Then certain of the vagabond Jews, exorcists, took upon them to call over them which had evil spirits the name of the Lord Jesus. So he called him Lord Antichrist, because he did not know brother Jesus, saying, we adjure you by Jesus whom Paul preacheth. And there were 7 sons of one Sceva, a Jew and chief of the priests, which did so. And the evil spirit answered and said, Jesus I know, and Paul I know, but who are ye? So the people who were trying to extort, they were sensible, you know, so they spoke out. And the man in whom the evil spirit was leaped on them and overcame them and prevailed against them, so that they fled out of that house naked and wounded. And this was known to all the Jews and Greeks also dwelling at Ephesus. And fear fell on them all, and the name of our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus, and not the Lord as Lord Jesus as the Antichrist call him, was magnified. And many that believed came and confessed and shewed their deeds. So many who believed, they confessed, and then they openly declared their deeds. Many of them also which used curious arts brought their books together and burned them before all men, and they counted the price of them and found it 50,000 pieces of silver. That means in Christ Jesus you need Holy Spirit, not the books. So mighty grew the word of God and prevailed. Remember that there are many people who question me that, do you believe in the written Bible or Holy Spirit? So I tell them, I believe in Holy Spirit, not the written word of the Bible. So be careful. There are many people worse than Jews.